We have some full screens from an article that you collaborated on. It says, among other things, Iran has obtained a cache of advanced missiles based on a Russian design, obtained 19 of the missiles from North Korea. The missiles could, for the first time, give Iran the capacity to strike at capitals in Western Europe or easily reach Moscow. So let's talk just a little bit about these missiles that Iran apparently has gotten, that we've learned through this WikiLeaks material, and how significant it is, and what kind of information we have now that we did not have before.
Well, Joe, the missile in question is something that's called the B-25, and it is a North Korean derivation of a Russian missile. The significance of this is that we knew before that the Iranians had likely obtained it, but we did not know if there was an American assessment that indicated that, in fact, they did have the missile. And what was contained in one of the diplomatic cables that we obtained was that, in fact, the U.S. assessment is that there is a Iranian capability here. The Iranians have not test flown this yet, so we don't know whether they really know how to operate it.
So as far as we know, at least right now, they're trying to figure out how to make their own and perhaps make it better?
Well, if they have 19 of the North Korean model, they probably wouldn't need to make their own. The bigger question is, could they fit the warhead of this missile with a nuclear device if they ever got to the point of actually making a nuclear weapon? We don't believe that they have done that yet, and they're probably still a number of years away. And even then, it's hard to make them small.
Perhaps the most important question that a lot of people would ask is, if you have missiles like these that you describe in the article, information that came to you through WikiLeaks, how far could these missiles go? We're talking 1,500 miles, 2,000 miles, and that would mean going from Iran to where?
It would mean going to Iran to about the middle of Western Europe. Maybe a little shy of that.
So,
and
Moscow,
on the other side, going as far as Moscow.
Right, which is interesting because these are Russian-designed missiles, right?
That's right, although the Russians did not sell them to Iran. North Koreans got a hold of the design and then appeared to develop the missile themselves. A few months ago, the North Koreans held a parade at which they showed this missile for the first time. That was the first evidence we had that the North Koreans actually had fielded or produced the weapon.
Now, a couple other questions just about the process here of your newspaper deciding to go with some of this stuff. First question, I think, would be, it's clear that you talked to the administration about what to release on the cable that gave out all this information and sort of worked with the Obama administration to decide what not to release. And the second question is, are you going to put a lot more stuff from this latest WikiLeaks release out there for your viewers, your readers to read?
Well, as you said at the beginning, there are about 250,000 cables in the WikiLeaks archive, and the Times did not obtain it from WikiLeaks. However, they did get it through a third party. There will be about 100 cables that will be published on the Times website with small excerpts of them in the newspaper edition itself. The decisions about what to publish and what to redact were entirely the Times' decisions, but the Times did go to the Obama administration in an effort to make sure that we had redacted the most damaging material for, say, dissidents or sources or informants. And the administration did ask for a number of other additional redactions. The Times agreed to many of those, but declined on a few.